जय श्री प्रभुपाद।
हरे कृष्ण
नाम प्रभु की जय।
वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू
फॉर द समरी सेशंस ऑफ सोलफुल जपा
सेशन
8।
सो
इन दिस लास्ट 8 सेशंस वी हैव प्रैक्टिकली कवर्ड
The two cue cards. The first one. Called presencing.
The presencing
round.
Or
Sevak.
Sevya.
Mala.
In the second round
was
Shraddha Mala.
Or defeating.
The fating round.
As I told you,
word introduced by me, faith. There is no English word like that.
But it is very useful
to differentiate,
to make faith into a verb. Faith is usually a noun. But now I am using it as a verb. Because I can have so many faiths in my mind. But those faiths. It's just a philosophical faith or just in my intelligence. I don't actually apply it. One sense I know Krishna is not different from his name. That will be in my mind. I have faith.
Intellectually I have that faith.
But when actual Nama is being uttered
and he is manifesting,
I'm not seeing that Nama as Krishna himself.
I'm not applying that faith.
Applying that faith is called faithing. And that I explained to you,
especially in the case of the presence of the Lord.
That presencing the Lord actively is presencing his mind. So anyway, that covers the first cue card and the second cue card. Second cue card I have given 16 points of faith
and then some more things I have given
and eventually I am preparing
all the major quotes I will give under that module 91.
Module 90 I have given the mind of the Lord
Nama Prabhu.
Now the third round is about divine dependency.
Divine dependency means essentially for good soulful japa.
One of the biggest obstacles to getting spiritual results from japa
is the offenses that we perform
in our relationship with the Nama Prabhu.
Inappropriate consciousness which we relate with the Nama Prabhu.
So as long as these offenses are there,
we don't really get the full association.
The effect of full association.
That is the reason why devotees chant for several years and they find some difference in their life. But if somebody chants for several years, it should not be some difference. It will be total transformation of one's consciousness. So this is due to offenses. Now, to counter these offenses, no doubt we should try to avoid the offenses. But many of these offenses are inevitable due to our weakness. For instance, inattentiveness. Due to our weak mind, we may not have the concentration to be attentive, etc., etc. Many reasons will be there. Inabilities. So, in spite of our desire not to make offenses, we will end up making some offenses. Number one. Number two, to succeed in chanting the holy name of the Lord the way it should be chanted, honorably, respectfully, lovingly, with humility, etc. It requires Lord's blessings in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is called Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate. Namo Mahavadanyaya means the most munificent. Munificent means without cause will give out. Causeless mercy. What they'll give out? Krishna Prema Pradayate. Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate. Krishna's love is given. Therefore, and it is very clearly mentioned in Chaitanya Charitamrita, that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very easily forgives these offenses. Now in this connection, I want to bring out a very important perspective of Hare Krishna Nama Japa. Hare Krishna Nama Japa is chanting of 16 words made up out of Hare, Krishna and Rama. There are three seeds, seed words, seed names. From that the Hare Krishna string is formed. Now this 16 Hare Krishna names, Hare Krishna and Rama word names, put together as Hare Krishna string and Hare Rama string as we chant in the Maha Mantra, it is the Surupa of the Nama, Prabhu. It is Surupa of the Nama Prabhu. Shabda Surupa. Shabda incarnation. What is the Surupa of the Shabda incarnation? The Surupa of Shabda incarnation is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. The string of 16 names. Now I am going to explain to you how this Hare Krishna Mahamantra represents Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Because the Shastras say that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or the close associates of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, including in Chaitanya Charitamrita, it is revealed. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Radha Krishna Nayanya. None other than Radha and Krishna combined in one body. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself. Come down. Radharani. Krishna wanted to experience what Srimati Radharani is experiencing as bhakti towards him, because he is at the receiving end of bhakti. He wants to be at the giving end of bhakti and experience that rasa. Therefore Krishna combined with Radharani's feelings for him. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is called Bhaktavatara. Who is the greatest Bhakta? He is Srimati Radharani. And entire Leela of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not like Krishna's Leelas, like killing the demons, etc. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's entire Leela is about liberating the living entities by by means of showing what is bhakti. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's life is an embodiment of how to be a pure devotee of the Lord. So he taught Kirtaniya Sadahari. He taught the Sankirtana movement. He preached the glories of the holy name. He taught how to live like a Vaishnava. These are some of the things that characteristically come out of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's life. Krishna, when he came, what came out is what he manifested to this world is killing of demons and, you know, so many things. As a Supreme Lord. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu manifested as a devotee, so much so that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, though he very confidentially revealed his form as Radha and Krishna combined to two of his very confidential devotees, externally for all practical purposes during his life, he didn't propagate that he is Radha and Krishna together. No. His entire life is known as a devotee. So much so that he set an example. If somebody said, oh, you are the Lord himself, you are the avatar of Lord himself, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu closed his eyes. No, 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 this is Mayavadism. I am just a devotee of the Lord. I am servant of the Lord. So he set this. This is also another example. Especially, you know, when in Benares, when they saw how glorious his knowledge of Shastra and everything, then everybody said, oh, you are Narayana himself. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu blocked his ears. No, 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 no. He wanted to show, though he is actually Narayana himself. So as far as the confidence, as far as the devotees of Lord Chaitanya is concerned, his confidential and followers of his great confidential associate Rupa Goswami and others are concerned, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is seen and worshipped by devotees as non-different from Radha and Krishna combined. He is Krishna himself. And he is very merciful in that particular form. Now the critical point I am coming to is that Radha Krishna Nahi Anya is revealed in Krishna, by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. He is revealed in the Leelas of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Think with respect to Ramananda Raya and with respect to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. They saw actual form, Radha and Krishna together, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's form. Now what is the Hare Krishna Mahamantra? Now I want to connect that to Hare Krishna Mahamantra. What is the Hare Krishna Mahamantra? Hare Krishna Mahamantra consists of Krishna's name and Radharani's name. Hare is Radharani's name. Hara is Radharani, the energy of the Lord. Hare is his vocative form of Hara. Krishna means all attractive aspect of the supreme absolute truth is called Krishna. Then we have Rama. Rama means one who is engaged in transcendental pleasure in association with Hare. Transcendental, infinite bliss, Rama. Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So Rama is also Krishna's name only. Krishna is also all attractive, it means. And Hare is Radharani's name. So if you take the string of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, if the names of Radharani is non-different from her, if names of Krishna is non-different from Krishna, then you take this entire string of Hare Krishna, 16 name Hare Krishna. There are only two personalities there, Radha and Krishna. That means they are the names of Radha and Krishna combined. And Radha and Krishna combined is who? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Therefore, it is said that if you chant this Hare Krishna Mahamantra, you are worshipping Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is a particular form of Yajna Purusha who receives this chanting and hearing of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, Japa or Sankirtana, whatever it is. So it should be made as an offering unto him. If you say Krishna is non-different from Krishna's name, By chanting Krishna, you are worshipping Krishna. By chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. By worshipping this mantra, you are worshipping Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So the identity of the mantra, total mantra, because in each bead there is a mantra, isn't that? We're not just running over beads, simply. One bead, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So the mantra as an identity, mantra surupa is 16 words, shabda, particularly arranged in a particular way, not that you can say Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, all that you cannot say. There's a transcendental science behind it. The Lord has willed, the Supreme Lord has willed to come in this particular way. So you respect and you chant in this particular way Hare Krishna and hear the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. You are worshipping Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And if Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is being worshipped through chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, offenses are not considered. It all depends on your consciousness. If you want to approach Radha and Krishna directly by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, yeah, might as well completely free yourself from offenses to get the full results. So therefore, Prabhupada explains in one place that we have to invoke the mercy of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. We have to chant Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shiva Sadi Gaur Bhakta Vinda before we chant our Hare Krishna Mahamantra, to remind us that I am completely depending upon Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to do offenseless chanting. In spite of that, if offense is there, you alone will forgive me. Because you are Namo Mahavadanyaya. You come down to give mercy. So let me show you some of these quotes where I have derived this conclusion. I have not derived this conclusion. These conclusions are in Chaitanya Charitamrita. I'll show you the quotes of these conclusions. And then also the logic when you connect these quotes. How? Serving Hare Krishna Mahamantra is same as serving Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chanting and hearing Hare Krishna Mahaprabhu is like pleasing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So in other words, pleasing Nama Prabhu means pleasing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, because Nama Prabhu is a sound form of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, being Radha and Krishna. And significant that he only came and propagated this in the whole world. There are other evidences also. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, now let me go to those quotes. So, this is in Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna Varnam Tusha Krishnam Sangopanga Shtra Parshadam Yajnai Sankirtana Prayer Ejantihi Sumedashaha. In the age of Kali, intelligent persons perform congregational chanting to worship the incarnation of Godhead, who constantly sings the name of Krishna. Although his complexion is not blackish, he is Krishna himself. He is accompanied by his associates, servants, weapons, and confidential companions. Now, there is another place. So that was in Srimad Bhagavatam. Here Prabhupada's purport in Srimad Bhagavatam. After all, human life is meant for pleasing Narayana, and this can easily be done by performing Sankirtana Yajna. Whenever there is congregational chanting of the holy names of the Lord, Gaura Narayana, the Supreme Personality of Godhead in his incarnation as Lord Chaitanya, immediately appears and is worshipped by Sankirtana Yajna. This is a very, very significant quote of Srila Prabhupada. He uses the word Gaura Narayana, the Supreme Personality of Godhead in his incarnation of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, immediately appears as is worshipped by Sankirtana Yajna. Okay, next. When we chant Hare Krishna Nama, We are pleasing the personality of Godhead as a string of names of Mahamantra. Okay, this is not the quote. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu repeatedly he prophesied. Prithvite ache yatha nagaradi grama sarvatra prachara haibe morana. In all the villages and towns all over the world, everywhere my name will be preached. By the way, you please tell me, today all over the world Hare Krishna Mahamantra is being sung. Is it not? And here it is said, in the villages and towns all over the world, my name will be preached. So what does it mean? Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare is his name. Today it is a Hare Krishna mantra that's being chanted and sung all over the world. Hence Hare Krishna Nama Prabhu is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. Next. Yes. Another piece of evidence, which I already explained to you. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahi Anya. That is in Chaitanya Charitamrita. In the vision of a perfect devotee, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is a combination of Radha and Krishna. Radha Krishna Anya Nahi. So, I have explained, this is in module 80, I have explained, the Mahamantra is composed of three names, Krishna, Hare and Rama. Krishna is addressing Krishna as all-attractive, Hare is addressing all-merciful Radharani, and Rama is the name of Krishna indicating infinite bliss. So the Hare Krishna Mahamantra is also Radha Krishna Nayanya. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is also non-different from Radha and Krishna. Therefore, the personality of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, that is Nama Prabhu, is non-different from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Next. Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namane Gauratvishe Namaha. O munificent incarnation, you are Krishna himself appearing as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You have assumed the golden color of Srimati Radharani, and you are widely distributing pure love of Krishna. We offer our respectful obeisances unto you. So, as far as Gaudiya Vaishnavas are concerned, we, as the worshippers of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we have this revealed knowledge that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Radha and Krishna combined. Next. Nityananda Mahom Nammi Sarvananda Karamparam Harinama Pradam Devam Avadhuta Shiromani. I bow down to the Supreme Lord Nityananda Prabhu, who is awarder of highest joy to all, the bestower of holy name and the crest jewel of all Paramahamsa mendicants. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Havam Nityananda Mahom Nammi Sarvananda Karamparam Harinama Pradam Devam Avadhuta Shiromani. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spreads the holy name all over this world through Nityananda Prabhu and his representatives, who are all these transcendental spiritual masters in Gaudiya Vaishnava Parampara. Next, it is significant that Srila Prabhupada instructed us to chant the Panchatattva mantra. See, there is a reason for all this. Please, those who are not doing it, after each mala, beginning of each mala, invoke the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by chanting the Panchatattva mantra. Sometimes it was saying, no, somebody has started this practice, Prabhupada did not tell this, all those things, some controversy. No, here it is very clear, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, before we chant every round, to attract the special mercy, this is not Prabhupada's quote, Prabhupada's quote is coming, to free us from offenses in chanting Hare Krishna. Krishna's and Radharani's mercy to us through the chanting and hearing of the Mahamantra comes through special mercy of Nityananda Prabhu and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Next. Yeah, here Prabhupada says, so, to become immediately in ecstasy of transcendental love, if you chant the Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, it is easier. There is no offense in chanting this Panchatattva. But there is offense if you do not properly chant Hare Krishna mantra. There are 10 kinds of offenses, you know. But in chanting Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, there is no aparadha. You chant in any way, you will get the result. This is a difference, taste. That is variety. Although there is no difference by chanting Hare Krishna, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda and Hare Krishna mantra, Mahamantra. But still by chanting this Panchatattva, you will get immediately quick result. Please hear what Prabhupada is saying. Therefore, our process is to chant the holy name of Panchatattva and then we chant the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So you got it. So it is established by Srila Prabhupada. About Prabhupada Prana Mantra after each bead, I am not sure whether that was there during Prabhupada's time. But definitely this Prabhupada has instituted that you chant Panchatattva Mantra. And it is natural for us as a disciple of Srila Prabhupada, chant Prabhupada's Prana Mantra. At least remember the spiritual master chanting. By chanting Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutle Shimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namine. So, this much, you know, is now very clear. If you have faith in everything that Prabhupada said, if you have everything that Chaitanya Charitamrita said, Chaitanya Charitamrita revealed about who is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, everything. When you are chanting Hare Krishna Nama, this full Nama is a personality of, just like Krishna's name is Krishna. Radharani's name in the Hare Krishna Mahamantra is Hare, Hara. Okay? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's name in the Hare Krishna Mahamantra is Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Suppose Prabhu, you ask, Prabhu, whose name is this mantra? One obvious answer is Radha and Krishna's name combined. Another answer is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's worshipable name. Now, I will come to the next point today which I want to communicate. Having given this background, because our third round is dependency round. Dependency round means essentially, O Mahaprabhu, please give me your mercy so that I can do offenseless chanting. That is a bhavana for the third round, dependency round. So for that you need to first know about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and that is why I have explained to you about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And also more information we have got, the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's link with this particular Mahamantra. So very, very, very deep link is there between this Mahamantra and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. O Mahaprabhu, I fully depend upon your causeless mercy to offer offenseless seva to Nama Prabhu with Sadbhavana. We have to pray for Lord Chaitanya's mercy in order to really taste and develop deep relationship with Hare Krishna chanting. As Prabhupada said, note the words that Prabhupada said, that it is very quickly we get results of our chanting. If you remember Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, or if you think, if you simply understand that I am pleasing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by this chanting. I am pleasing Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by this chanting. And next point I'll I'm going to talk about in connection with this. One more concept, this module, this is in module 80. What I already spoke to you is in module 81, I have already posted. Now I'm going to talk to you about module 81. Because these are all the basis for what I am going to write in module 93, which is for dependency round. Okay. So now we have concluded the relationship between the Hare Krishna Mahamantra and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Now let me introduce this concept called quantizing one's attention. To start off this subject, this is also a very good experience you get if you understand this. And you will understand, and you have to understand. That is the right way to chant. Let us say somebody is chanting. There are two ways of chanting. Two ways of perceiving your chanting. Chanting externally looks same both, but two ways of perceiving it. Another one way is, you like a tap water. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Like a tap water. Why I say tap water? Because after each mantra, in your attention there is no separation from the next mantra. So a nanosecond gap is required between one mantra and another mantra, so that you have recognition of each mantra. Because the mantra is the one who is receiving your service. Please understand. The whole mantra is the Nama Prabhu. Hare Krishna Nama Prabhu means whole mantra. So you are chanting and hearing the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Japa is not repetition of Hare or Krishna or Rama, no. Japa is repetition of, on each bead, what are you chanting? One full mantra. And that's what you are repeating. So what is the unit seva? The unit seva is one Hare Krishna Mahamantra. So he is a savior. He is the one who receiving my service of chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. The Maha Mantra, the 16 strings, is being worshipped. While they were being worshipped, each Nama is building up the string. I am aware, I am attentive, I am hearing each Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. But very clearly I know it is, I am going to go to the next bead after I finish this. That means I am, word by word, I am chanting and hearing as part of the string, building up the string. To give you a good example, I will tell you, when we do aarti to the Lord, we focus on the lotus feet of the Lord, then mid part of the Lord, then the face of the Lord, then the entire rupa of the Lord. Is it not? You just don't stick to 4 feet only. But part by part, it builds up the Satchidananda rupa of the Lord in your in the worshipper's mind, then the total personality. Similarly, please understand, let's say the question may come, Prabhupada says, chant and hear each word. Yes, you should hear each word. But you should understand that each word of this 16 words of that build up the personality of Nama Prabhu. Just like you cannot say, you cannot separate these two things. Like in worshipping the Lord, feet cannot be separated from the mid part of the body, nor cannot be separated from the face of the body, nor from the whole body. But at the same time, for building up my, I have to go through the feet of the Lord, my meditation. Similarly, if you see Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, is the entire body of the Nama Prabhu, sound body of the Nama Prabhu. Then the next sound body comes, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. He receives the service. And then next one, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. He receives it. Next one, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Now do you understand this? So much significance is the discovery of mala by the introduction of mala to the japa by the acharyas. Because this mala quantizes your attention. That means it gives a nanosecond break in your recognition. You're not for Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. No problem, you can chant very fast, provided in your observation, in your awareness, that means attention, in your knowing attention, there is a recognition. It is through knowing attention we recognize, no? There is a recognition not only of individual, no problem, you must be hearing and knowing each sound. But there should be a recognition that on one bead I am chanting this many shabdas. And one over, two over, three over, you are not thinking. When you chant on one bead, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, you are not counting. How many Hare's and how many Krishna, you are not counting. But after chanting one mantra, yes, you have to count. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this I call it as quantized attention. Recognition should be there. It's all not very, very difficult to understand if you simply follow this meaning. Meaning, what is this? On each bead, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Ram. Day you were taught itself to japa, how on each bead you please chant Hare Krishna and repeat it. So the focus is what? Not Hare Krishna, Rama. The focus is what of your offering? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. It's one unit of offering. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare, so much different from tap water chanting. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. You are not recognizing the Savior. Savior means you should know who is the personality whom you are serving, you should know. So he should never go out of vision. Again, I give you example. I come to your house, you are feeding me something. You are serving me food. And I sit before it and then you have forgotten me. You are simply absorbed in only putting different things in the plate. You have forgotten. Can I be separated from that seva? From the actions of the seva? No. In your mind, you cannot lose focus of me as the person who is receiving that seva. So seva is the one who is receiving the seva. So who is receiving the seva in japa? Not individual Hare or Krishna. Individual Hare Krishna also. Okay, leave it. But that's not what you are repeating. You hardly think of that. The one who is receiving it is the mantra. Because you are chanting, this is mantra meditation, you are chanting Maha Mantra. Maha Mantra has an identity. Maha Mantra has an identity. A unique identity as Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. It will make a lot of difference to your quality of japa if in your mind there is a recognition, because especially tasking, you recall all the directions that I have given for tasking. Tasking is a build-up of how many units? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. When 16 words are completed, I feel success. Yes, one seva is built up. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Note, we are not moving the bead. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. For each word we are not moving one bead. Because whom are you doing the seva? The seva who is being received is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Now another very important thing I will tell you now. Very important. What is real hearing? We have understood that hearing is association of the Lord. Hearing is touching the Lord. Hearing is all effects, all positive effects of chanting comes from hearing. Because Nama Shabda Surupa Avatara, Shabda Avatara, hearing is touching that sound God, the Surya of Satchidananda. So to hear, you need to, there is general hearing and there is careful hearing. I am using the word Prabhupada used. Distinctly chant and carefully hear, he said. Chanting distinctly, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. What is this careful hearing? Careful hearing is just like if you are going to a scent perfume shop. You want to buy a particular kind of perfume that you vaguely remember in your mind, you are not able to express to the shopkeeper. So shopkeeper will tell you, "Yo, here, try this, try this, try this." So you open each bottle. You carefully smell. That means you sharply smell. Is it this? No, not this. Not this. This kind of smelling, isn't it different from you're walking by the shop side, perfume side? Some general smell is coming. Oh, perfume shop is there. That smelling is different. This smelling is different. Yes or no? Big trick I am telling you. Big trick. Big difference it will make to your japa. Sharp hearing. It needs practice. Okay. So, you can chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Generally, Hare and Krishna, Rama are vibrating. But if you are sharply doing it, this pattern in which the Nama runs, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, is also recognized by hearing. That means there is a high resolution hearing. Low resolution means from distance you see a forest, all green trees. This is low resolution seeing from a distance. But when the flight goes closer and closer and closer to the forest, you will see details of each tree. Your attention can discern each detail. Similarly, with little advanced practice, your attention will catch each word, not only each word, the patterns. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. You will know. Basically, now I am in Hare Krishna string, I am in Hare Rama string. That means you are really sharply hearing. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So I call this phenomena as knowing the signature of the sound. Signature means what? Each person's signature is unique. Similarly, Hare has got a unique signature sound.
Krishna has got a unique signature sound. Yes or no? Does Hare sound like Krishna? No. Does Krishna sound like Hare? No. Does Rama sound like Hare? No. Rama sound like Krishna? No. So Rama is a unique signature sound. Krishna is a unique signature sound. Hare is a unique signature sound. And when there is high resolution, then finally all of them built up together, Hare Krishna string and Hare Rama string put together, is a unique signature sound. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. It sounds different from Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. It sounds different. Signature is different. Unauthorized signature. That is not the signature of the Shabda Surupa of the Avatara. The Nama Avatara Shabda Surupa is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I mean, these are all things that you can keep it in your mind. Oh my God, so much to aspire for in Japa. Not that tomorrow you can do this, I am saying. But if you can do this, your consciousness, 16 rounds of sharp hearing of Hare Krishna Nama Prabhu, it blows your consciousness. Purification happens so fast. And so, liberating experience. There is no reason why Prabhupada is saying, as soon as you chant Hare Krishna, you are liberated. There is a statement like that. Because it is so potent. It is, if you are able to keep your mind attention on hearing sharply, then the difference, it makes very high quality of japa. Nothing else in your mind except the movement of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Only that moves. There's no movement of thoughts. There shouldn't be even movement of body also. Unnecessary. Turning the head, this, all these things. Ultimately, best japa is energy should not go for that also. Completely your movement of the Shabda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Bead after bead after bead after bead. The one of the reasons in all my practices, I go on saying bead after bead is meant for quantizing the attention. With a quantize. Quantize means what? It's like a packet. Tap water means what? Continuously flowing. Right? Quantized means what? Here is one little water falling. Then next falls. Then next falls. Next falls. There's a gap between all this. Quantized. Light, they say, is both wave and quantum. This is from physics. Light is both wave and quantum, they say. And when it actually hits an obstruction, it behaves like a quantum. When you don't say light hits a surface, then it shows the properties of a quantum, like a photoelectric effect. When the light goes through two holes, it shows interference pattern. Like a wave it hacks. Okay. So now you take the same air example. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. The moment you give attention to it, then it is like in quantum mechanics, they say it collapses the wave function. It acts like a particle. In other words, when we concrete, then the Nama touches us. Sharp hearing is very important. Attention is the one
that connects an attention, not general attention, specific attention, sharp attention. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Ram Hare Hare. It requires practice. All this is facilitated by the different devices that the acharyas have given us. Mala itself, day one itself, you are quantizing and chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Just like the farmer, first day, he was all quantized only because one mantra is over, next mantra is over. That means his attention was not like a tap water, was quantized. Only after some time, after practice, we want to finish the round. You just mechanically you are moving bead to bead. We do not know the significance of moving bead to bead. One unit is over, another unit is over, another unit is over. No. Instead, you are just mechanically, automatically, your mala is moving, hand is moving, no problem. Let it move automatically. But as long as if your attention is, you know that one pleasure giving is over, another pleasure giving. You see cue card number on Preeti, you will see. When you come to that, we will again discuss more about this. So today I have introduced you to these two things about how important it is to bring, to feel that the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra is, chanting of Hare Krishna is nothing but worshipping Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and only by His mercy you can get the real Krishna Prema, Krishna Prema Pradayate. You can have realization on Radha and Krishna through Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda Prabhu. And Harinama is the way Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught. And therefore now I pray, completely depend on the divine mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in my today's japa. That is the third japa. That's the third mala. Specifically, devotional service is always rendered by depending upon the Lord. In the material world, let's say you serve a poor person. Usually you use the word serve. Okay, you serve, let's say you serve, of course you use the word to serve the master, to serve the servant, everything. Whatever it is, in the material world, you serve the servant, you serve the master because you want to give him something he doesn't have. He has nobody else. Or you serve a poor man because he doesn't have something else. That means you, out of your own strength, you are giving something to the servant. You are giving servant something to the poor. You are giving something to the master. But here, the person who is served is Atma Rama. He does not need anything. He is completely independent, self-reliant. He does not depend for his even ananda on anybody else. And that is the reason even he does not depend on ananda for anybody else. And in teachings of Lord Chaitanya, this understanding is so nicely given. That Srila Prabhupada says, explains, probably from quoting from Chaitanya Charitamrita, he explains that when Krishna wants to enjoy, from him he manifests as Radharani. Radharani is Krishna's body only. For rasa, for ananda, he expands. That means many people say, oh, he is so much dependent on Radharani. How is he absolute truth? Yeah, he is her. She is him only. That means he is completely self-sufficient in his ananda. He doesn't need Jiva's help. But it is good for us. So devotional service, even though the word service is used, please understand, in the material world, somehow service means you are giving something, it comes. Actual devotional service means you are giving bhakti. You are not giving anything. Everything that is instrument, for instance, all the shakti that is required, that is belonging to the master only. Just like the child takes money out of his father's pocket and says, Papa, I want to buy a birthday present for you. Tomorrow is your birthday. Tomorrow is your birthday. Please, I want to buy a present for you. You know, give me 100 rupees. Give me 100 rupees. It's a loving exchange. Father will take out 100 rupees and give him. He goes and buys 100 rupees gift and gives to the father next day. Does he think that it was his capacity? No. His love was his, but nothing else was his. So therefore it is said, we can never give anything to God because everything belongs to him. What we can give is our love. So therefore, if we, out of our love, preeti, we give our attention, that is pleasing to the Nama Prabhu. So, in other words, there is a sense of, I am completely dependent upon the Lord to chant my 16 rounds, my concentration, all this yantra, this entire machine should function properly, no? If I go into coma, how can I chant? I cannot. This should function properly. And who does it belong to? The Lord. So always, and if I do it very nicely, sharply, hearing successfully for 16 rounds, one after the other, you need material ability also. That means your mind also should cooperate, isn't it not? You are completely dependent on the yantra also. And that yantra is the skills of this yantra. You are completely dependent upon the super soul. So to do excellent chanting as instructed by all these modules, we have to do it under divine dependency. The Bhagavad Gita also Krishna says, in such devotional service, completely depend upon me. In material world, suppose I have a big debt. I cannot call my friend and tell, please completely depend upon me and give me some money, I want to clear my debt. Does it make sense? And you say, okay, my friend served me. Or he say, okay, I served my friend. Does it make sense? It is his money and he didn't depend on the friend to save him from debt. He offered, giving something from me. Take my money. But in bhakti seva, whether it is chanting or whether it is building temple or whether it is cleaning the floor of the Lord, the expertise in seva depends upon jnana, bala and kriya, so many things, so many factors, material factors also. All that, my Lord, I am completely dependent upon you. I can only offer, just like the son took 100 rupees out of pocket and transformed into a gift. Similarly, all your energies I can transform it into, with my bhakti I can transform it as an offering unto you. But the substance is yours. You are the owner of everything. And you are my owner also. So I have to give everything that I have claimed as mine. If I give my body, it's because I am a thief. Now I should give what I thought it was mine. So first level of surrender of a thief is what? He will give back all the stolen things. Everybody in the material world, Prabhupada says, is a thief. Because he doesn't recognize that what he has is belonging to God. God is not saying, don't have it. I have given it for you only. But if you have the mentality that it is mine, that is called karmi mentality. Even if you do good karma, the result has to come by his blessing only. He is a giver. Not a blade of grass can move without his sanction. So this same level of dependency should be there in offering a quality japa. I am depending on you, my Lord, for concentration. I am depending on you for concurrent chanting, come hearing. I am depending on you not to get distracted by all the different thoughts that come in my mind. I am depending upon you to offer the right kind of feelings to the Nama Prabhu. So depend on Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Depend on Srila Prabhupada. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's life history is itself a big example of this. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whose ecstatic chanting of Hare Krishna, look at his history. His spiritual master told him that you chant Hare Krishna Hare Krishna. This was told by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to the pandits in Banaras. Why are you are a sannyasi, why are you chanting like this and dancing in the street? This is all not for sannyasi. Sannyasi should be sitting and studying Vedanta, should be always churning the Vedas. Why are you singing and dancing like a neophyte? This bhakti is all for neophytes. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, why are you chanting this? He said, I don't know anything. My guru told me, you are a murkha, you are a fool. You simply chant this mantra I am giving you. So guru gave him this mantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. He took this mantra. From Isharapuri. And he started chanting. He said, I started chanting. I do not know what is happening to me. I am going mad. This mantra is making me go mad. I am in ecstasy. I do not know. I do not want to stop chanting. That's all I know. I am following his order. Just in the same way. Just see. No heavy complication and all these things. My guru has ordered me. I will chant. Srila Prabhupada has ordered me to do 16 rounds. Simply order carrier, obedience, rasa, I shall chant. And by his strength, by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's strength, my chanting will come out perfect. It is said that if one remembers Guru's order, all the shakti to fulfill that order also comes with that. This is another trick. If you remember Guru's order and you want to fulfill that, and in remembrance you go and act, even things without your, beyond your shakti, you will be able to do it. Mukam karoti vachalam pankulam gayate girimit. So even you can cross over the, lame can cross over the mountains. Dumb can become eloquent by the mercy of the spiritual master. If you have faith in his order and execute. Okay. Thank you very much. We'll meet again day after tomorrow. Jai Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna Nama Prabhu ki Jai.